We choose to go to the moon in this decade and do the other things, not because they are easy, but because they are hard.
What did I say?
During the meanwhilest.
During the meanwhilest? No, like that at all.
Well, hello, it's Dexter and me, back on YouTube with yet another video that is so fun-filled and action-packed, it should probably be illegal, or at least come with some sort of government health warning. First off, apologies for the hat. I haven't turned into one of the Backstreet Boys, but I am filming this video in my bedroom with a backdrop of a heavily lit bay window. And if I didn't wear this, my head, my bald head, would disappear into the abyss. Today's video, as promised, is all about recreating or copying somebody else's image. Now, if you're a fan, quite frankly, you should be a fan of Ted Forbes' Art of Photography channel. It's excellent. Ted sets these things he calls photo assignments, where he gets you to choose an image, copy it as exactly as you can, and then use the knowledge you've gained from copying that image to create something original and of your own. And in his last assignment, which was back in, I think, either March or April, he was looking at the work of Josef Sudek, a Czech photographer who operated, I think, between the wars, really, and after the Second World War. He was a Czech photographer who did lots of landscape stuff, street stuff, and probably more, most famously, his still life stuff. And it's one of those still life images that I'm going to attempt to copy today. It is a flower in a glass of water, well, a flower bud rather, in a glass of water, lit with what I think must be natural light. On the face of it, the photo doesn't really look all that much. It looks quite a simple picture. but recreating it is far from simple. There are so many little detailed nuances in the scene, which I think trying to copy those is going to be absolutely impossible. So I've got all the stuff together that I think I need. I've got the natural light of this lovely box bay window. I got my own artificial LED light as well. I've got some paper for a backdrop. I've got something to create a shadow with, and I've got something to light the subject from above, because I think it's going to be in such shadow from the direct sort of source of light that I think trying to get any sort of detail into the highlights of the image is going to be quite hard. Now, obviously, Joseph didn't have Photoshop, so I'm not going to use Photoshop. The image that you will see as an end product is the image that I've created in camera with no editing at all, well, apart from cropping some stuff out. There's no editing at all. I was going to say no heavy editing, but there's no editing. It's going to be the straight out of camera raw image. So I'm kind of laying my lack of talents as a photographer bare, really, I guess. The process for shooting this image is quite a complicated one. I don't want too much natural light because I can't really control that coming through my window, and that's going to make creating the shadows that I want quite difficult. I'm using a small LED light, which is quite bright, to light the scene from the side, and I'm going to place a stand that I usually have my laptop on when I'm using my laptop on my lap to create or to cast the major foreground shadow. I've then managed to position a light somehow. It's my headlamp from above, which I will then use during a 1.5 to 2 second exposure, hopefully, to paint some light onto the image. Now, I don't want to use any filters because I don't think Sudek would have had anything like that to use. So everything's going to be done naturally. So the settings on the camera are quite alien to me. I'm going to be shooting at the lens's smallest aperture, which I think is around f32. So around about f25 in full frame depth of field equivalent. But I need that f32 and an ISO of 50 to give me a long enough exposure time to paint some light onto the leaves at the top of the image. And this is going to be a difficult thing to recreate. Right, well, here is my final image. And if any of you are wondering why I put JFK's famous moon landing speech at the start of this image, it's because when he was referring to going to the moon and doing the other things, not because they are easy, but because they are hard, I think one of the other things he must have been referring to was recreating a Josef Sudek still life, because this has proved really, really difficult to do. The main problems, or the main things that I couldn't actually replicate, were the very, very, very subtle reflection of the flower bud and the leaves behind the image. I couldn't find anything translucent yet opaque enough to create that that reflection. I tried using some card wrapped in cellophane, and that came the closest, but it wasn't good enough. There were too many creases. And then the color of the card kind of like corrupted the image, for want of a better word. And the other thing, which should have been simple, was getting bubbles in the glass. I couldn't do it with water. No matter how many times I took out and dried the flower bud and the stem and the leaves down, then put it back in, I couldn't recreate the bubbles. So I then tried doing it in lemonade, would you believe? Which tasted kind of nice after anyway. So I would like zhuzh the flower around and then try and take the photograph. But I found that the bubbles, as they were rising to the top during the longish exposure, were just disappearing. So I couldn't get the bubbles to do what I wanted to do. And as you can see, it's not an exact replica of Josef Sudek's work. Firstly, I couldn't find a glass the same shape and size, would you believe? So I had to use a jar. But that doesn't matter. That's not important. What's also not important is the fact that the flower and the stem and the bud are not exactly the same shape and size as the ones in the Josef Sudek image. That doesn't matter. But what does matter, as I've said, are the tiny details. I just couldn't get those. I couldn't do them. So I failed. I have failed in recreating a Josef Sudek image. And as easy as that looks to do, it isn't. Trust me, it's not. It was very, very hard. And JFK, amongst many other things, was right on this occasion too. Anyway, I hope you found this video interesting and entertaining and as fun-filled and action-packed as promised at the start. I don't know if you can hear that. Somebody's doing some work outside and you may not pick it up on this microphone, but a bit annoying. Thanks very much as usual for watching. I hope you enjoyed it. Next week's video is going to be the review of my GoPro Hero 9 Black. And then I'm going to take a little 3 or 4 week break, if you don't mind, to recharge not just my batteries, but the camera's batteries. No, everything. I need a little bit of a rest now. And yeah, that's just about it. So Dexter and I will see you next week. Until then, stay safe, stay well, stay COVID free. Yes, Dexy, I'm coming. He wants to go out, and we're going to go out to a local park to take some pictures. And he's getting rather excited. He loves going in the car. Yeah, we'll see you again. Did I say stay well? Yeah, stay well, stay safe. Look after yourselves. Look after your loved ones. And we'll see you again very, very soon. Bye-bye.
Is there a heaven? I'd like to think so. Standards of living, they're rising daily. But home, oh sweet home, it's only a saying. From bell push to faucet, in smart town apartment, the cottage is pretty, the main house a palace.